The Kiwi country music supergroup are heading out on the road again.
The Highwaymen are all stars in their own right, and despite being in their 70s and 80s, these mates still carry on like teenagers.
Come pour some liquor on me, honey. Ooh, it's a real live boogie and a real live hold down. Don't be a bitch, come take it to the floor now.
Long before Beyonce went country, Gray Bartlett was topping the charts. Brendan Dugan was a household name. Dennis Marsh was on his way to becoming our biggest selling country star. And Eddie Lowe was touring the world. Their names are carved in stone. Their album sales, stratospheric. They're in movies and countless TV shows. The Highwaymen are a living, breathing hall of fame. And they're heading back on the road, playing every nook and cranny in Aotearoa, just like they've always done.
So you guys are just about to embark on a huge tour. I'll start that again.
Welcome to our world.
So you guys are about to embark on a huge tour, 20-plus dates. How do you train for that?
God, I don't know.
We don't.
We don't really.
Training is on the road.
One day at a time.
Yeah, it's a good song, man.
And here's our new face number three tonight, Brendan Dugan, just 16 and mad about country and western music.
And it was do what you do, do well, boy, do what you do, do.
For me, anyway, growing up, Brendan, your voice was all over an ad that used to be on it. Felt like every single ad break in my childhood, and that was Golden Coast Chicken. I never ate any, but I knew the jingle.
Why should chicken always be the same? Better try the one with the country name and country fame. Golden Coast. Haven't done that for a while.
Oh,
yeah, Jeremy.
I don't know how much joy that is for
him. I get too excited.
I don't know if I can go on.
Good evening, live on stage, we have the Great Bartlett Band, Brendan Dugan, Eddie Lowe.
In the 80s, these guys were everywhere, but mostly on a hit TV show called That's Country.
Let's talk about That's Country and the golden time, probably you would say, of New Zealand country. Would you say that was the golden time of New Zealand country?
It was the golden time in those at that time, but there's a new, there's a really golden time now for country, and of course it's
Kaylee and all that, right?
That's current star Kaylee Bell of Waimate, who would have been right at home on That's Country.
That's one of my songs, right down.
But there's a story to be told about a nasty dispute between Gray, Brendan, and the producers of the show. And it sounds like something right out of the Wild West.
People broke into my property in Auckland.
Oh, yeah.
Trying to steal
I had a
stuff.
Restaurant in Queen Street called Country Gentleman. That went up in smoke. I'm not saying someone from that situation did that, but there was no reason for it to go up in smoke, that's for sure.
What, this is all over That's Country?
Well, it was all part at the same time.
Yeah, I think it was a lot of...
But not saying anything.
No.
You know.
Wow.
We didn't think we were so important.
All right. What are you guys looking forward to most on this tour?
For me, it's about, from the last tour, the exhilaration of seeing all these thousands and thousands of people and all of them wanting to come backstage. And I must be honest, I was absolutely totally blown away. I never thought we'd get more than 10 or 15 people there. And it was just packed with all these people wanting to photos with us and sign autographs.
The camaraderie thing is very, very important too. We as get on all very, very well. Yeah. We love doing what we're doing, and as Grace said, it's a set audience. There's no bigger buzz than having a full house of 1,000 people and just going, well.
Is there any underwear thrown at you?
Not anymore.
No.
Was there ever underwear?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Yeah. 50 years ago?
Yeah.
If you look at the country in terms of New Zealand, where's the city or town most likely to chuck undies at you?
Oh, God, Jeremy.
I mean...
Rotorua, maybe?
Rotorua.
Rotorua.
My hometown.
Yeah.
Trouble is, I can't see them coming.
Despite his limited eyesight, Eddie Lowe has enjoyed a stellar career ever since joining the Māori Quintikis in the mid-1960s.
Well, I've always been in country music when I was a kid. I used to listen to people like Gene Autry, Roy Rogers, Wolf Carter, you know, and... But then rock and roll came along, Elvis came along, so I started adding some of that into it.
Just call my name. By
29 albums, Dennis, I was reading.
30
albums. Can you name all of them?
Almost. I can only count to 20.
I love it.
Who is the biggest ladies man? And look, just have a think about this before you answer.
He was in his day.
My day's passed now, you know, too many...
We all say that, don't we?
But I've got a lovely wife.
Yes. What happens on the road, mate, stays on the road, remember?
I was going to say, I mean, you guys must have broken a lot of hearts travelling around New Zealand over the years. Are you ever concerned on this tour that they're all going to appear in one place at once?
That's a lovely thought.
I can quote a Kevin Greaves statement that... all the women who used to drool over us now dribble.
Yeah, there we are. That's it.
It'd be nice to do another song, though, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
What do you guys, want to play anything?
All right. You ready, boys and girls?
Go.
You ready? On the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again.
Again, going places where I've never been, seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again, like the gypsies, we go rolling down the highway. We're the best of friends, insisting that the world keeps going our way, and our way is
on the road again. Can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again. All right, great.
That was such a pleasure to talk to those guys.
Delightful.
Great bunch of guys. And the New Zealand Highwaymen hit the road in June. We'll be back in just a moment.